is sitting there. Poison.
That is very good.
Very good.
Polemic is another one there as well. A strong attack on something. A
polemic?
Yes.
Chance. Very good. Good man.
Parvenu. It's quite an insult, isn't it? Somebody who's a bit of an upstart.
Yeah. Recently arrived.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah. Nouvelle riche, all that.
Thank you.
Nick Hewer.
This is where the countdown favourite comes in. Giudice is there for seven. Really bad luck, Des. I thought that was quite likely, but it's not in, I'm afraid. Yeah, there is a seven there with satiety. So if you're sated and you're full, that condition is satiety.
Thank you. Thanks, Richard. 53 to seven's taken care of. Anything else?
There is an eight there, yes. To adduce something is to bring it out or develop it, like potential, for example. Mm-hmm. And the act of doing that is called eduction. So that will give you an eight.
Eduction?
Yeah.
OK, so your origins of words.
I'm going to talk about a really British word here. Yeah, you don't think you'd find it in American English. And so we're talking about languages at the top of the show. I think this one is distinctly British. Slightly dated, but it's kind of having its heyday again. And I think this is why Chris Ryan on Twitter asked me where naff comes from. Something naff, it's quite an elusive term. We all know what it means. But if it's naff, it's just a little bit twee, perhaps, or just, you know, its definition. There have been many attempts to explain the origin. Lots and lots of different... They actually have two different meanings, and that the verb, as in naff off, is simply a euphemism for something a lot stronger, and that seems quite like backslang. Now, backslang was a form of code, if you like, but often quite obvious code. Sometimes you have to really work at it. So yob is backslang for boy. That's how that one turned out. And we think that naff possibly turned is short for fanny, and I'll leave that there. Polari, and back with round the horn, because in Polari, the phrase naff omi meant a formed a lot of Polari. Naffa, G-N-A-F-F-A, which meant a despicable person. And that would mean naff has actually lost quite a lot of its sting since it first started, but as I say, a quintessentially British term.
That's brilliant. That's wonderful.
Yes, a rainer is in the dictionary as an irrigation device which delivers a rain-like spray.
Whoa. Right. Zany, that's good. Yeah. All right. And so, Des.
Six folders, all one word. Yes, six times.
Indeed.
Have a great weekend.
Indeed.